I was born right here in downtown Savannah. I was raised on the edge of town at the Vernon River. Now, after I wrote a song you might be familiar with called Moon River, they renamed that whole place out there Moon River, so you could put your feet in it like I used to. But when I was 19, I went to the Savannah River. I jumped on a steamship line and I went up to New York and I started writing lyrics to songs. I wrote songs like Accentuate the Positive, Goody Goody, Feast the Creepers, One for My Baby, Woman for the Road, Satin Doll, The Summer Wind, The Autumn Leaves, Blues in the Night, That Old Black Magic, Come Rain and Come Shine, I Remember You, I Can Stand Here All Day.
Tell you my song.
After I decided I'm doing all this work, I want to control it. So I got smart. A lot of people don't know this about me either. I started Capitol Records out in California. In fact, that building is still sitting out there. It looks like a stack of 45s. That's a stack of CDs to you younger people. That was my idea. That was my design. And I'm real proud of it. And Savannah's proud of me. For my 100th birthday, they built me a real nice monument on the other side of town.
This is the first house in the country to have indoor plumbing. They used a cistern, so there was a bathroom in here before there was one at the White House. Up here is the Juliet Gordon Love Birthplace Museum. She's the founder of the Girl Scouts. She grew up here in this home, and then she just moved a few blocks around the corner when she married Andrew Lowe II.
My name is Catherine Green. Those who know me well call me Katie. However, I am sure you find Katie as a more familiar with my husband, the Revolutionary War hero, Nathaniel Green, of whom I am exceedingly proud. Many are of the opinion he was one of General George Washington's most gifted and dependable soldiers. Now that I have no doubt, but I will tell you, it's a miracle that my husband even entered the military. You see, he was born in Rhode Island, raised a Quaker. Now the Quakers were quite put out with him when he started studying philosophy as a young man. They read him out altogether when he took up dancing. In 1793, I invited Eli Whitney to come stay with me to tutor the children. And while he was at Mulberry Grove, he filed a patent for a machine that would change agriculture as we know it and allow cotton to become king here in the South. We call that machine the cotton gin.
Fare thee well, my dear friends, and please do remember me. Fare thee well.